नमस्ते। टुडेज डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन इज अबाउट मेकिंग ऑफ लावाश। लावाश इज वन ऑफ द हेरिटेज ब्रेड ऑफ टर्की एंड यू नो इन दिस डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन आई विल गाइड यू स्टेप बाय स्टेप मेकिंग ऑफ लावाश। यू नो लावाश इज कंसिडर्ड एज ए ब्रेड ऑफ आर्मेनिया टू एंड इन ईरान लावाश इज ऑल्सो नेम बाई नान ए लावाश। द एग्जैक्ट मीनिंग ऑफ लावाश इज टू नीड। So at the end of this video demonstration you will be able to make lavash.
For making lavash we have required all purpose flour, that is refined flour. So refined flour is one of the main ingredient of lavash, and to give the taste into the lavash we are using butter. By the help of butter our lavash could be rich enough. It will give the buttery taste and flavor into it, and then we have to use salt into it. Salt, because by the help of salt we can give them the salty taste into our lavash. And for the sprinkling purpose we have required sesame seeds. So sesame seeds, by the help of sesame seeds it will give the nutty flavor, and some roasted sesame seeds flavor into our lavash. And for making and binding our dough we have required water. So by the help of water we'll need our dough for making our lavash.
So for making lavash we have required refined flour, butter, water, salt and white sesame seed. For the recipe we have to weigh our ingredient first. So firstly I am weighing my refined flour, that is 250 gram of refined flour. Then I am using butter, that is 50 gram of butter. So butter also helps in making the lavash crispiest. Then I am using salt into it, so 6 gram of salt for making a lavash. So 250 gram of refined flour, 50 gram of butter and 6 gram of salt. We have to knead our dough into our dough mixer. I am adding 125 ml of water into it for kneading our dough. Now our dough has been ready and I am just stopping my dough kneader. And while you are handling with this kind of the machine, you must have to care for the all the instruction. You don't have to rush, because your safety is one of the most important tasks while you are handling with the equipment. So I am just showing you the like a texture of our dough, how it's look like to be. So it should be soft enough and it should be clear from the top. So by this texture it should be very much smooth from the top. The reason behind I have to spread it for the like a thinner sheet and all. So I am just placing my dough for now 10 minutes. I have to spread my lavash dough here, and it should be thin, like 1 mm of their thickness, because it is very much thinnest bread. And in India this much of thickness is generally found for the rumali roti and all. So you have to care for your thickness first. So for a beginner people you have to care for, you don't have to go with the machine part and all. So I am just spraying out some water here for placing my this dough onto tray. So you just have to spread your dough like this, right? And your tray would be the perfect place for the dough spreading. And firstly you have to give them the some rest of 5 seconds and all, then you have to cut it out, because it may can shrink out. So I am cutting here. So now I am shaping my lavash into some fancy shape, and also I am giving them the triangular shape here. So It's up to you. You can also keep your lavas into a square shape. So I divided my dough into two parts. So half I am giving the rectangular shape, straight stick shape, and half I made of out of this, the triangular shape. So you don't have to care for. You can also leave them into the square shape of your lavas dough. So after doing this, you have to just again spread it out, spray it. For a spray will help into the two things. First is it also protects from the moisture, and it will also helps into the like a sticking of the this sesame seeds on the top. Lavash is ready now. So I am placing my lavash tray into my preheated oven for 10 minutes. Now this is our preheated oven that is onto 200 degrees Celsius, and now I am placing this tray into preheated oven for next 10 minutes. Now our lavash has been baked. It's a proper color of the lavash. It seems to be very much crispy and firm enough, and just I am showing you the how to do the plating of the lavash. Our lavash has been baked, and you know I can show you the like a crispiness sound of our lavash. So it is sounds to be very much crispy. So for making lavash, we have been used refined flour, butter, white sesame seed and water, and we baked our lavash at 200 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. So that's all about the lavash. Hope you understood this video. Thank you so much for watching.